In this series, we will go through React hooks. We will learn what they are, what is their purpose, and finally how to use them. I expect this series to have about 10 videos, and this is the introduction. Just before we start, you should already be familiar with the basics of React. Simply, things like React components, JSX, which is the syntax used for elements, and ideally props and state. However, I will do my best to explain those concepts even if you aren't familiar with them. So let's get to it. Now, if you remember, in React, there are two common ways to write components. The first one is to use class-based components, where you make use of predefined methods like render, component.didMount, and so on. In those components, you have very easy access to the state and to the component lifecycle. The other way is to use functional components, which are just JavaScript functions. However, in the past, there wasn't a way to use state or the component lifecycle in functional components. And this is where React hooks come in. All they do is allow us to use all of those fantastic React features without writing a class. This includes state management, component lifecycle, and much more. But this isn't the end. In fact, hooks allow us to do some things even classes can't do. You can write your own hooks to make your code much more usable and therefore much more powerful. I will cover this in one of the future episodes. So now we know why React hooks exist and what they allow us to do. The next question is, what hooks are there? In the upcoming videos, I will cover each of the existing React hooks in detail, but just so you have an idea, I will quickly go through them now and explain what they do. The first one, and one of the simplest hooks, is the useState hook. All it does is allow you to use the React state. The next very important hook is the useEffect hook. In short, this hook basically gives you access to the full component lifecycle. The useContext hook allows you to make use of the React Context API, and the useReducer hook gives you a good way of managing complex state. The useRef hook also allows you to store data similarly to the useState hook, however, it doesn't re-render the component whenever this data changes. This hook is also commonly used to access elements in the DOM. The useMemo and useCallback hooks allow you to optimize your application performance by using memoization. Now there are three hooks left, which aren't used as often as the other ones, and I will cover those in a future video. And that's all. In the next video, we will set up and prepare a simple application where I will dive into each of the React hooks and demonstrate how to use them. If you have any suggestions or questions, let me know in the comments and I will answer every single one of them. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to leave a like and subscribe to see more videos like this in the future. Thanks for watching.